Hello, I'm Eduard Serradell from the Robotics Institute of Barcelona, and I will present the work Robots Non-Rigid Registration of 2D and 3D Graphs, published in CVPR 2012. And this is a joint work with Przemek Glowacki, Pascal Foa from similarity.pl, and with Jan Kibik from CTU Prague. The problem we are going to deal with is robust registration of 2D or 3D graph structures, like the ones we can see in these images, like retina vessels from angiographies, or neurons appearing in brain image tags. The motivation of this work is that we want to find the connectivity of the neurons of the brain, and to do that we have access to two kind of datasets. One dataset is a light microscope image tag, where we can see a big area of the brain, where we can see the neurons and how they connect with each other, and an electron microscope image tag, where it's a much higher resolution, and we can see the details of the synapses or the mitochondria, etc. What we want to do is we want to, given the segmented neurons present in those datasets, we want to find the transformation between those neuronal structures using a non-rigid alignment, and finally we want to embed the EM stack into the LM microscope. The method that we are going to use is, given two graphs obtained for these two images or image tags, which means that we take the neuronal structures and we represent them as a graph, where the 2D or 3D points are the nodes and the edges are the connectivity between those nodes. So given these two graphs, we want to simultaneously estimate point correspondences and recover the non-rigid transformation between them. And we are going to do that using a nonlinear registration using Gaussian processes. Why Gaussian processes? To answer this question, we'll have a look at my previous work, where we were dealing to parametric model, to transformations. We have a known model, and we are using parametric models to recover these transformations. We used the Kalman filter to estimate the parameters of the transformations, and we were dealing first with rigid transformations on homographies, and a second work was on non-rigid transformation on projective cameras. In this new project, we don't know anything about the transformation of the underlying the two neurons, so we will have to use a non-parametric model, and the Gaussian processes will be a good way to do that. In my first work, we were trying to find homographies, so a pair of images related by a wall plane. And the method we found to do that is that we iterate tomography priors. We project the model points from one image to the other using one of those priors. We select a best match from key points candidates from one image and the other, and we update the transformation parameters using the Kalman filter equations. To illustrate that, we have the model image and the new image, and we projected the key points from the model image to the new image, and we selected one match. And using this match, we update the homography prior, and we progressively refine the mean and covariance of this homography prior, until at the end we find a final good alignment of the two images. We were comparing to Prozac, and we obtained better results because we used geometric information and appearance information to deal to this problem, and Prozac used only appearance information. In the second work, we were dealing with non-rigid 3D reconstruction from a single 2D image, like the ones appeared in the heart, where we have a 2D X-ray image and a computed tomography of a volume of the heart. So we were using, as a model, a projective camera with a deformable model for the heart, which we modeled as a low-dimensional PCA. And we treat in a similar way that in the case of homographies, where we simultaneously estimate correspondence and we recover the articulate deformation shape by first estimating the 2D to 3D correspondences and then updating the parameters of the model using the Kalman filter equations again. Then finally, we progressively increase the flexibility of the generative model and we iterate until we get a final solution. So for example, here we can see a good iteration of the model where we progressively get to the final solution using some correspondences between the 3D model and the X-ray image key points. So why Gaussian process? In the new problem, we don't know the underlying deformation, so we want to represent arbitrary nonlinear deformations by the means of an unparametric model. Then we also want to simultaneously solve the matching and alignment, and Gaussian process gives us a possibility to perform a sequential nonlinear regression. Finally, we want to perform a guided search, and we use the Gaussian process to predict the mean and covariance to guide the search. Using a Gaussian process, we can define a nonlinear regression like that. Let's assume we are given n correspondences between points in both sets. We can predict the location of any other point with a mean and variance given by the standard equations of the Gaussian process. Particularly, we will choose the kernel function, which is composed by a linear plus a squared exponential kernel. This implicitly defines a mapping function composed by a linear plus nonlinear transformation. The set of hyperparameters appearing in the kernel function weakly constrain the family of allowed deformation. So, given this expression for the kernel function, the main prediction can be rewritten as we can see in the slide, with a first term which is a linear transformation and a second term which is a nonlinear transformation. To solve the alignment, we will separate the algorithm into steps. We will first perform a coarse alignment, where we iteratively match the junction nodes by establishing k correspondences between graphs, and then for each matching node, we search for potential correspondences in a region defined by the mean and covariance, and then we choose one of them to update the mapping. We iterate until we reach a large inlier consensus, and we use the geodesic distance to constrain the search. If there is no new candidate, we backtrack and we begin the iterations again. To illustrate the steps of the coarse alignment, we'll show in this example of a retina how first we pick two random correspondences and use these correspondences to define a mapping between the two graphs. Then we increase the number of correspondences, and each new correspondence restricts more and more the mean and covariance of the mapping, and finally we get to the final solution of this coarse alignment. Then we will perform a final alignment where we allow every point to have a correspondence between the two graphs. So at the end we can match the two graphs in a very fine resolution. We will first present the synthetic results, where we perform some deformations to a synthetic rigid tree. We bended it and we added outliers to this tree, and we compare the performance of our algorithm to a point cloud registration algorithm, like the state of the art coherent point drift, and then with the previous version of our algorithm, where we are using a parametric model with an affine transformation. Of course, we are better than the coherent point drift, because we are using the intrinsic information of the graph as the geodesic distances, and we are better than the previous version because we were using before an affine transformation. For the real results, we will present first the results on the angiography of the retina, where we wanted to align the graphs of the blood vessels in two images of the same retina viewed by different point of views. We can see how our algorithm, in spite of the number of outliers, can find the final solution, the good solution, whereas the CPD is failing. It's trying to adapt the point cloud to every point, and it's failing due to the high number of outliers. Here's an example of a good iteration where we progressively first find the coarse alignment using the junction points, and then we use the fine alignment to finally find the good solution. We also present results on angiography of a heart, where the two images are taken at different times from a heart cycle. And again, our method can find the solution in spite of the height deformations, and CPD cannot find the solution because of the outliers again. Again, an iteration of the iterations of our algorithm. Finally, we will present the results on the example which motivates our research, where in one hand we have the neurons of the EM stack, on the other hand we have the neurons of the LM stack, and finally we present how we can align the EM into the LM stack. In this final animation, we can see how we can align the two graphs, but also we can present a mapping of every voxel on the image stack. To conclude, we presented an algorithm which can match graphs with neither appearance information nor initial pulse estimate, which handles partial matching and nonlinear deformations, and we used a GP approach to model the mapping and guide the search. As future work, we want to extend this work to deformable surfaces, and we want to improve the greedy search, the random choice of the first two correspondences, and we want to use the algorithm in a pipeline with automatic segmentations to effectively recover the LM versus EM alignment.